In this example, we are given that inside a uniform sphere of density rho, there is a spherical cavity whose center is at a distance L from the center of the sphere. And we are required to find the gravitational field strength inside the cavity. Now, the situation is like this. Say this is a big sphere in which a cavity is made. And the center of cavity is located at a distance L from the center of this sphere. This is the center of a sphere and the C1 is the center of cavity. Say we are required to find the gravitational field at a point P inside the cavity. Then procedure will use the similar which we have done in the previous example, like due to the complete sphere we find out the gravitational field at P and we subtract the gravitational field due to the mass which resides within the cavity. Here let us consider the sphere is of radius R1 and the cavity is of radius R2. Then total mass of a sphere we can write as the density multiplied by 4 by 3 pi R1 cube and mass of cavity which can be written as small m, that will be equals to density multiplied by 4 by 3 pi R2 cube. Now in this situation, if due to the whole sphere gravitational field at point P is G1, then we can say G1 will act in this direction. Say if the position vector of point P with respect to the center of a sphere is x, then we can simply write gravity at P due to complete sphere is, this can be written as G1 and the value will be as it is opposite to the position vector. We can write it by the expression of gravitational field inside a solid sphere, that is minus G mx by R1 cube. This is the expression we use. Similarly, gravitational field strength or gravity at P only due to small m is, small m is just the mass which is enclosed within the zone of cavity and say it is located at a position vector y, then this G2 will act in the direction radially inward toward the center. So here we can write G2 vector will be minus of, here also we can use x as vector and here also we can use g small m y by R2 cube. And at P, GP can be given as this G1 vector minus G2 vector, because G1 is due to the complete sphere and G2 is only due to the mass which is within the cavity region, which is going to be removed, then only cavity will be created. So we substitute the values, G at point P can be written as, if we substitute G1 and G2, this will give us G, and if we substitute the masses, we can write capital M as 4 by 3 pi R1 cube rho. So here R1 cube gets cancelled out. It will be 4 by 3 rho. Here also when you substitute M as 4 by 3 pi R2 cube into rho, R2 cube will cancel out. So this will be G multiplied by 4 pi by 3 rho. And we are having parameters left are y vector minus x vector. And for this point P, y vector minus x vector can be written as this L vector or negative of L vector if L vector is towards the center of gravity. So this G at P vector can be written as negative of 4 pi rho G by 3 L vector, where L vector is the vector directed towards the center of cavity with respect to the center of the sphere. So we can see at point P gravitational field exists in the direction of L vector, or it is independent of x and y. That means inside cavity everywhere the gravitational field which is developed by the mass of this sphere will be uniform, and it is along the direction of L vector and its magnitude is given by this. So that will be the answer to this problem.